Hello everyone, welcome to all of you for the lecture series of Naval Architecture for MEO examination. So this is the second lecture of our Naval Architecture series. So in earlier class we have discussed about the load acting on the horizontal plane. We have discussed how to calculate the pressure acting on the horizontal plane as well as how the load is going to act on the horizontal plane. In today's class, we have a discussion on the load acting on the vertical plane. Now, the load acting on the vertical plane, as we have discussed earlier, so vertical plane, in case of a ship, the vertical plane means you will have a bulkhead and the second one is a side shell. So these are the two vertical planes you can consider in case of a ship. So what are the things we are going to discuss in today's class? In today's class, we are going to find out the load acting on the vertical plane and how this load is varying from the free surface to the bottom of the ship. That all the things we are going to see in today's class. So now consider you have a vertical plane. I will consider for time being the vertical plane is only a rectangular plate. So in actual case the bulkhead won't be a rectangular, but as this is the starting of the classes, so we will consider as a bulkhead is a rectangular plane and the water is up to the top of the bulkhead. The water or any liquid is up to the top of the bulkhead. So the water is there up to the top of the bulkhead. So if you want to understand what I am discussing here, you can think like this. You have a ship, I'm looking in a profile view, and you have a bulkhead like this. You have a bulkhead like this. So consider that water get enters in one of the hold, and this water is filled up to the top of the bulkhead like this. Now the picture which I have drawn here, this is the transverse view of the one of the bulkhead. You can see this is the transverse view of this bulkhead. So if you see the bulkhead, transverse bulkhead in a profile view, it will look only a single line. If you see the same bulkhead in a transverse view like this, it will look, actually it will look like this, but we are considering this bulkhead as a rectangle only for the calculation, to ease of the calculations. I hope it is clear. Now this bulkhead is having a water on only one side, okay, and because of the presence of the water, or you can consider any liquid, how much is the pressure is going to act on the vertical, this plane, that is the bulkhead, that we are calculating now. So how to proceed for that? So the water is there up to the top of the bulkhead, so the free surface H is equal to zero will be at the top of the bulkhead. So what I will do now, I will take one small strip the The area of this strip I will call as A. I will call it as A. And the distance of this strip from the free surface, that is H, like this. So if you want to find out, the pressure acting at this location, we can use the same formula. P is equal to rho g h. If you know the pressure acting on the strip or at the location of the strip, pressure is rho g h, then you can easily calculate the load acting on a strip will be pressure into the area of the strip. So it will be rho g a h. So the formula which we have derived, this is for the load acting on the particular strip only. But I want to find out the load acting on the whole bulkhead. So what we will do now, we will integrate from the top to the bottom of the bulkhead. Integration means it's like a summation only. So what I will do now, you can find out the load acting on bulkhead. It will be, you can write like this, rho g a1 h1 plus rho g a2 h2 and so on. So you can write the same thing like this, rho g will be remains constant. You can take out of the bracket and you can write a1 h1 plus a2 h2 and so on. So you can calculate. So a1 h1 plus a2 h2 is like this, so on. If you do the addition of this, you can write the whole bracket, you can write like this, a into h. So the formula becomes load acting on vertical plane will be rho g a h. So this is the load acting on the vertical plane. Rho g a h. This is the load acting on the vertical plane. So try to understand what are the terms are there in this formula. So the rho is the density of a liquid, g is the acceleration due to gravity, a is the area of a bulkhead, and h, now this is a very very important term, h is distance of centroid of plane from free surface. So In upcoming classes, we are going to use this formula to calculate the load acting on the vertical plane. So this is the formula we are going to use. So all of you, please try to understand the formula and the terminology which is used in this formula. So now we'll have one numerical. So if you understood the numerical, if you understood the proper concepts what we have studied now, you can easily understand this numerical. So read the numerical. A rectangular bulkhead is 10 meter wide and 8 meter deep. Okay, so I will draw a schematic diagram over here like this. So I have a bulkhead like this. So it is a 10 meter wide and 8 meter deep. It is loaded on one side only, means on one side of the bulkhead only some liquid is there. What is the liquid? With the oil of a relative density is a 0.8. Relative density is a 0.8. Calculate the load on the bulkhead if the oil is just at the top of the bulkhead. This is the sub-question A. Sub-question B is the oil is inside the above the bulkhead 3 meter up to the sounding pipe. 3 meter up to the sounding pipe. So how to proceed for this? The bulkhead is like this. We will see first sub-question A. The oil is up to the top of a bulkhead. Oil is up to the top of the bulkhead. The width is 10 meter and the depth of the bulkhead is 8 meter. So this is the first case. The liquid is up to the top of the bulkhead. They have given the relative density of oil, that is 0.8. Now what is the relative density formula? Relative density equal to the density of a medium, whatever the medium is there, in this case it is oil, divided by the density of a fresh water. We are going to compare the density of the medium with the fresh water, that is the relative density. Now relative density is given 0.8. The density of the fresh water, it will be 1000 kg per meter cube. So the density of oil will be, I will call now density of the oil, rho O will be 0.8 into 1000 kg per meter cube. It will be 800 kg per meter cube. The density of the oil is 800 kg per meter cube. So all of you please write somewhere here. So the question will be, find out load acting on a bulkhead. The formula for this, which we have already derived, that is rho g capital A into capital H. Now the definition which we have seen about the area of the bulkhead will be now the bulkhead is a rectangle, so you can easily find out the area of the bulkhead 10 into 8. It will be 80 meter square. Now what about the capital H? What is the definition of the capital H? Capital H is the distance of the centroid of the bulkhead from the free surface. So this is the rectangle. So the centroid will be from the top, it will be 4 meter. So the centroid will be somewhere here. So in this case, H will be 4 meter. So you will have value of everything. Rho is 800, G is 9.81, A will be 80, and H will be 4 meter. If you solve this, you will get the load acting on the bulkhead, and the unit of the load will be always in a newton. Always will be in a newton. So like this, you can find out the load acting on the bulkhead when the liquid is there up to the top of the bulkhead. This is the sub-question A. Now we'll move for the sub-question B. In this case, what they are saying, there is one sounding pipe. So liquid is not up to here now. There is one sounding pipe like this. The sounding pipe is there inside this hole, and it is like this. And water is filled inside the sounding pipe. There will be a liquid, and that liquid will be there on one side of the bulkhead, and whatever the liquid is there inside the hole, that all the liquid is arising up in the sounding pipe up to the distance 3 meter above the top of the bulkhead. So in this case, the free surface will be here. This is the free surface. H is equal to 0 will be here. H is equal to 0 will be here. Okay. Now to find out, so this condition also we have to change. Liquid is above 3 meter than the top of a bulkhead. Okay, so in this case, what will be the load acting on the bulkhead? What is the magnitude of the load acting on the bulkhead? So the formula will be remain same. Load is equal to rho g a h. A is the area of the bulkhead, that is not going to change. That will be 10 into 8. It will be 80 meter square. The only h value is going to change. So what is the definition of the h? H will be measured from the free surface. the location of the centroid will be remain same. That will be here only. It is not going to change. But the value of H, capital H, is going to measure from the free surface to the location of the centroid of the bulkhead. So it will be (4m + 3m), it will be a 7m. So capital H will be 4 + 3, 7m. So you can substitute the value of density, it will be 800, G is 9.81, area is 80, and H will be 7m. If you substitute all the values here, you will get the value of a load active on the vertical plane, that is a bulkhead. It will be in a Newton. It will be in a Newton. Okay. So if you see, now whatever the things we have discussed, you can see on the screen, you will find the actual values also. So what was the sub question A? Load on the bulkhead if the liquid is up to the top of the bulkhead. The formula will be this rho g ah. Rho is 0.8. why they have taken in the 0.8? because they have taken this density in tons per meter cube. There is no problem if you're taking kg per meter cube or tons per meter cube, answer will come same only. If you are taking this value in tons per meter cube, if you solve this whole thing, whatever the value will become, that will be in a kilonewton. If you are taking this density in kg per meter cube, the value will come in a newton. There is no difference in the answer. So the load acting on the bulkhead will be 2511 kilonewton if the oil is up to the top of the bulkhead. If the oil is inside the sounding pipe up to 3 meter up, so that time the load is going to act on the bulkhead will be 4395 kilonewton. So we will have one more numerical, so you can easily understand the concept which we have discussed. So please read the numerical. A ballast tank is a 15 meter long. A ballast tank is a 15 meter long, 12 meter wide. So I have drawn one schematic diagram over here. So you can consider this is the ballast tank. This is a 12 meter wide, and consider this is the length. That is around 15 meter and 1.4 meter deep. 1.4 meter deep. So this will be a 1.4 meter deep. Is filled with the fresh water. The fresh water density will be 1000 kg per meter cube. Calculate the load on the top and the short side. So everyone easily find out what is the meaning of top side of this tank. The top side means this one. I will just so the top side tank means this one. You can see this is the top of the tank. So the hatching thing which I am showing, that is the top of the tank. And a short side. Now what is the meaning of short side? You can see in the red color which I have shown, the dark red color, that side is called as a short side. So if you want to find out the area of the short side, will be area of the short side will be 12 into 1.4. 12 into 1.4, that is the area of the short side, and the area of the top tank, you can say that will be 15 into 12 meter square, which is the area of the top. Now again, there are two conditions they have made here. The tank is just completely full, so these are the two conditions are there. The tank is just completely full means the tank is completely filled up to the tank top. This is the first condition. So if this is the condition, that time you have to find out the load at the top and load on the short side. Okay, so if you see in this numerical, this numerical is a combination of the horizontal plane and the vertical plane. This numerical is a combination of the horizontal plane and the vertical plane. Okay, so how to proceed for that? So I will take the first condition, that the tank is just completely full, means water is there up to the tank top, and two things we have to find out: load on the tank top. This is the first condition. So this will be a horizontal plane. The formula becomes P is equal to rho g h. So in this case, h will be, now the sub question, the condition one is a tank is just completely filled, means up to here the water is there. So free surface will be at the tank top, that will be h is equal to zero. So in this case, h is zero because we have to find out the load acting on the tank top when the water is there up to the tank top. So that time the pressure will be zero Newton per meter square. Then what will be the load on the tank top? That will be pressure into area of a tank top. So that will be P zero, area will be something A into zero, that will be zero Newton. So load on the tank top will be zero when the tank is completely filled up to the tank top. So this is the load on the tank top. Now we have to find out the load on the vertical plane, that is called as a short side. Short side is a vertical plane, and water is there up to the h is equal to zero, up to the tank top. So h is equal to zero will be at the tank top. So this is the condition: load on a short side, that is a vertical wall. So in this case, the load formula will be rho g capital A capital H. So in this case, H will be distance of centroid of the short side from the free surface. So it will be just a half of this depth of the tank. The depth of the tank is 1.4 meter, so half of that will be 0.7. So capital H will be 0.7 meter, and the area will be area of the short side. It will be the width of this tank was 12 meter, so area will be 12 into 1.4. You will get some it will be 16.8 meters square. So you need to substitute only the value here. Rho G A H. Rho will be, they are saying the fresh water, so it will be 1009.81. Area is 16.8 into H square is 0.7. If you solve this, you will get the value of a load. Load acting on the short side. So like this, you can find out the load acting on the vertical plane. When the water is there up to the top of the tank. This is the sub question A. The second thing is, the liquid is there inside the sounding pipe. They are saying here there is a head of the 7 meter of the water above the tank top. Yes, we can consider that there will be some sounding pipe will be there, and liquid is up to the 7 meter above the tank top. So this depth is 1.4 meter. So in this condition, again, question A will be load acting on the tank top. I am talking about the water is there above the tank top, 7 meter above the tank top. So in this case, the pressure at the tank top will be, the formula will be remain same. P is equal to rho g h. H will be 7 meter. So you will get the value of load will be rho g h into area of the tank top. Rho will be 1009.81 into h will be 7 meter, and the area of the tank top will be 15 meter by width is 12 meter. 15 into 12 meter. So like this, you can easily find out the load acting on the tank top when the water level is above the tank top 7 meter. Okay, so this is the condition one. The second condition will be, now when the water is 7 meter above the tank top, how much will be the load is going to act on the short side, means on the vertical plane. Load acting on a vertical plane, that is short side. So the formula will be remain same. Load is equal to rho g a h, but in this case h will be measured from the free surface. Distance of centroid of the short side from the free surface, it will be 7 plus 1.4 by 2. It will be 7 plus 0.7. It will be 7.7 meter. So h will be 7.7 meter. Area, the short side is 1.4 into 12 meter. Then you will get the same formula you are going to use. Load is equal to 1000 into 9.81 into area 1.4 into 12 into h is 7.7 meter. Like this, you can find out the load acting on the short side. This is a vertical plane. I hope this answer is sufficient to understand the concept. In the next class, we'll have a discussion of the few more numericals which are related to the load acting on the horizontal plane as well as a load acting on the vertical plane. Some of the numericals I will do as assignments, or you can consider as a homework, and you can do the practice from your end. It will be to get the feel of this subject that should be necessary. So this is the one of the numericals. A vertical bulkhead 9 meter wide, 8 meter deep, has sea water on one side only to the depth of 60 meter. Means here the water level is not up to the top of the bulkhead, it is only up to the 6 meter from the bottom. Calculate the pressure in kilonewton per meter square at the bottom of the bulkhead and the load on the bulkhead. So the condition is like this. I will give just the idea, and you can try yourself. So this is a bulkhead is like this. On the depth of the bulkhead, 8 meter, and width is 9 meter. But in earlier numerical we have seen that two conditions we have seen: the water level is up to the top of the bulkhead and water level above the top of the bulkhead. Now in this case it is in opposite direction. Water level is below the top of the bulkhead. It will be somewhere here, and from the bottom it will be 6 meters. Like this. So we have to use the same formula for the vertical plane, and you have to do the calculations for that. You have to do the calculation for that. Okay, so all of you please try this numerical, and we'll have a discussion in the next class.